Yeah, man, dope music. Man, we got the boys in town. We got to get this episode done. Looking forward to it. Hope we have a good hunt. And, man, it's going to be a blast.
Daryl Moore, Camden, Arkansas, Season 3. We back, baby. Let's go.
Ricky Nicholas, Lafayette, Louisiana. 24-7 hunt. Let's get it.
Hopefully the drive was worth it, man, because this weekend, it's going down.
Gage Tally, a.k.a. Sweet Meat.
Ian Russell.
Aubrey Mack.
24-7 hunt.
Tired of waiting on the gun season. Let's get it started. Okay. I got to the hole just like James Harden.
Should have got Easy lined up, man.
I'm getting a haircut tonight, man.
Easy, I'm getting a haircut tonight.
I got 100 for him.
Come on, man. Come on. I'm all the way up here for my birthday. All I wanted to do was hang out with my bros and kill a green hair. That's it, man.
I was told not to drive this 17-hour drive from Florida. So to get on a plane, but I've been training my dog Goldie for 11 months now.
Drop your beanie down on your head.
Try to change my style, bro.
But I mean, that's your style. Go for it.
It was. Not no more. Get in that feet. Gear lined up. Trucks lined up. Boats lined up. But I got more water in my cup than we got in this lake. So it's a situation.
About to go see where these ducks are at. Hopefully we can get them, find them. Starting Saturday morning from the murder scene.
That first time we hunted a hole going that way, right?
Past that bend where we took the pictures at.
It was more narrow, and I remember seeing more sandbars. Okay.
So you want to go to our traditional spot?
Yeah, we can go look at this. And if that don't work, we can go in there and see.
All right.
I'm about to try to send it. I'm just saying how far I can go.
40 by my side, yeah, 40 by my side. I ain't scared of the woods, I keep some extra rounds. I can smell if you ain't right, I'm a bloodhound. The dogs in your area code, we coming to your town. Pull up to the farm, yeah, yeah, it's time to feed up. I can shoot a beat there anytime, that's a layup. Got the ones on lock, yeah, you can't even play us.
You hoping that they in here? I'm not hoping that they in here. Because it's prime real estate. When you see ducks flying, and you a mile within your hole, I take that as I'm in the game. Correct. So whatever today's win is, we want the opposite, but.
That was a mess right there. That's one group.
Man, quick update. We seen birds in the river, the mouth of the river. So we knew they were in the general area. And we got on foot about 3 miles in. Got to a hole. The hole was probably 2 foot lower than last year. Mallards. Mallards in the hole. Mallards in the river mouth, mallards on 3 mile radius. It's gonna happen.
We saw a few birds in the river and came to one of our number one holes and we saw a few here.
We're gonna see how it goes. You know, we ain't seen as many as we want, but hey, we at least we're seeing a few. So a lot of ways we like to use Onyx. In this instance, the river's low, water's low, real low. We go up the river and we try to find, you know, low spots in the woods, oxbow lakes. And then we go get out the boat, walk, see if it's got birds. So hopefully, you know, using that tactic will help people out. If the river's low, get on Onyx, find low water in the woods and get parallel to it, park your boat, and walk straight to it and see what happens.
How many ducks in
there? It ain't that many, but it's a few. It might be easier to get back here than the water low, honestly. You can see where you need to go back.
I got you at the boats all the way back there.
You see it?
I hear say it. I'm lost. I can take lost tomorrow.
That's a double homicide. All you gotta do is get in that boat. Just relax. It was coming, bro. Man, so out of all the times we were in the boats this weekend, I did get stuck one time. And I will say that my boys left me and my group back. And, man, I'm definitely going to take that to heart. So if they ever get stuck on the sandbar, I'm taking it on to the house. I see you whenever I see you. I ain't helping none of them.
Them sandbars are rough.
Sandbars were absolutely horrible.
Boom.
It's just a sudden stop.
It's just that little bend right there. Well, you gotta make that sharp.
Sharp turn.
We couldn't make that turn.
I was looking this way, and then I looked up, I seen them damn logs. Right, I tried to turn, it was already too late.
Man, that dude already met. Cannot drive, bro.
I turned into the sand.
You beached that motherfucker.
Yeah.
What?
Poop. Yeah.
You gotta get that boat unstuck. You gotta put a little muscle into it, you know?
You should have gotten a boat with a seasoned veteran of this. I'm talking about this river.
I'm gonna let Ian drive. We're gonna get stuck. I'm gonna try this.
I guarantee it won't. It don't.
I guarantee it won't.
I guarantee. How much you wanna bet?
I bet you $100. I bet you.
No. I like taking your money. I bet $1,700.
I bet you.
So you kill a walk here and
here? We might as well walk through here, bro. It's a 500-yard walk.
600, yeah.
Holes are dry, man. Like, not only they have not had water, but they like they had water in a minute. Bone dry, man. This right here is a duck hole. Hurry up. I need everybody in the boat ASAP. Yeah, so the whole off season, all I think about is duck hunting. Night before opening day, all I think about is other people. Other people coming to the dang on hole, so we gotta get out there early.
All that crap by me yesterday getting stuck. We ain't even made it to the spot. Not even close to the spot.
Of course, yeah, I got stuck. H2O, you need it to get a boat through there.
Hold up. You know, look, hey, Ian came out here and said he wanted to drive the boat. So I said, hey, get in the boat and let's drive.
Man, we weren't even 5 minutes into the river. Stuck like Chuck, man. I tried to tell him.
Hey, this hoe right here stuck.
He left us like 30 minutes ago.
He ain't made it though.
Yeah.
Call him to see.
Yeah, we got the hoe.
All right. We'll be there in a minute.
Hey, Jason, I knew that was gonna happen.
No, but
I had a navigator telling me to go that way.
This has started.
Why would you go to a sandbar?
I know for a fact, out of the whole crew, I'm the best boat driver we got. Man, they can count on me. That's all I do know. They can count on me this morning. Smooth sailing. It is what it is, baby.
I mean, come on, man. I'm the best driver, no doubt.
I gotta give it to Rick. Rick, he can drive that boat. With it being a flat bottom, he can drive it.
So from what I seen in the boats that I actually rode in and the drivers that I rode with, Renard was the best driver by far, getting to the hole.
Straight up though, I'm gonna be honest with you, my boy Renard Moody can drive a boat, bro.
Every boat I rode in, we were stuck, sadly, but I had to give it to my man, Renard Moody. He got us to the hole,
but Renard's the best driver in this river. Dude got some wheel time, some stick time. He know the cuts. And I think the biggest difference between him is he ain't scared, man. He gonna skin it back. So I take confidence in cruising behind him on that river. It get crazy, so. We'll go Team Moody on that one. This a freestyle off the dome. Nothing but the rest in my head. Air stay back, I stay ready. Arkansas boat race like in Drake. Get down right there, you gon' see me. It's in the market, got food with feet. Get down there, they stop by next. We kill ducks in that big fence. We go scout and find that rap. Then we get back and watch that. Little small margins for error, whether you 10 foot to the right, 10 foot to the left, you'll be high and dry or spinning around. So it's just anxiety, nervousness, competitiveness, and hope like heck you don't fall off the boat.
Pop rocks, 20 gauge popping, and we don't stop. 20 gauge popping, and them dogs drop. 20 gauge popping, and we got the grease hot.
We dropped an exclusive Mondo call this year. It was blue and white, so I wanted to match that up with my lanyard. Icy lanyard, all blue, everything.
Hey, Arvin, we got more G cars on the bank?
Yeah, this sounded good, you know it's O. We shot an 8, man, that's a Kobe. I can't wait to see Easy handle OD. He's the next generation, that's the son of Pete. It's an art to killing ducks, masterpiece. I'm in the water like a coral reef.
Huh?
A lonesome honker came in, everyone gave up on it, no one had a call. Me and Jason, we used a voice call, brought the thing in, got the job done.
Boy, first one of the year. Gotta put my hands on them. Gonna be a good year. In the way.
Man, I don't know what Aubrey had going on with that call, but I think coronavirus 19 hit that thing. That thing was sick, let me tell you. And I'm not talking about sick in a good way.
I had it since I was 16 years old. It's never done me wrong. Birds were turning. Daryl, you know, he's a cut down man. So look, I let him, you know, do what he does. Some birds curve, turn, come straight to us. And Daryl won't call him. So it is what it is. Let them hate. There's always going to be haters out there. And Daryl's going to be one of them. It's an art to killing ducks.
Probably the longest shot on the green head I ever pulled. I ain't come all the way from Florida for nothing. I don't let out the motor, ain't no stopping me. Bring the ducks down from the nose. Real pick down,
I gave Michelin Man, aka Ian, the hardest time of his life about him shooting, but hey.
Straight up though, I might have got stuck going into the river, but guess what I did do right? I put that Apex on them.
So this was my first season shooting Apex. Heard about them, heard about the different metals. Man, ducks will fall in vertical. I mean, lifeless, crushed. I'm a believer, I'm a fan. I'm with all my dogs just like gonna kill them.
Kill a mess of mallards and you know what's for dinner. I'm not gonna say no names, but somebody in the hole never had duck before. Hey, yo, come try this duck, man. You gotta eat it while it's hot, though.
Easy. Mm.
Fresh.
Yeah.
What's his first duck?
And Rick done fired the Coleman up in the hole. Man, we got sausage biscuits, we got roll-ups. He took a duck, got a medium rare, and man, this thing is slapping. Make you want to slap your mama, baby.
What? I'm getting up with that right now.
Boy, Rick is an absolute chef in the woods, in the duck hole. The sausage was amazing. The rolls was amazing. And just to let y'all know, I have never tasted a duck before this hunt.
We cooking one more.
We're cooking one more.
I never pass up another duck, meal, seared. My boy Ricky put that duck on that pan.
I cooked a sculpt one time. I feel like I had to figure out how to way to make a sculpt taste good because I ain't want to keep shooting if I ain't like them. Man, cooking them medium.
I'm telling you, bro, I swear to God.
Fat boy hunger, dude. I got to have something in that loadout box. Whatever I can find, gas station, Dollar General, whatever. We eating.
Somebody need to hire Rick at their kitchen. The next thing you know, I smell sausage, these little tortilla things. I don't know what they're called, but I ate them. Man, they were good.
I ain't even gonna give him too much credit when it comes to whipping up the sauce, but I will tell you, that man comes prepared. He'll take something out of the freezer, whether it's a frozen sausage or a Crispito. He can cook it up on the spot. He's always prepared. He has it in the Yeti go-to box. Hey, it is what it is. He's the man. Wrap him up in bacon,
cream cheese, jalapeno. McMuffin, courtesy of Rick. Call it Derek Jeter. 20 gauge on me, and she real
spicy. I think she looks real feisty. The start of a bird dog.
Good boy. Good boy.
Come back to the bank.
Now walk.
That's a good boy. There was a lot of doubts with Odie. I don't really have access to water. I don't have access to birds. But being hopeful and staying positive about it, man, I knew he was going to do good.
There we go, boy. Hold on now. Good. Wait a minute.
Come on,
come on,
boy. Come on. Come on. Good boy.
Oh, man. Odie, that's you, my man. Odie's first retrieve for a greenhead was priceless. It's indescribable. Just as I said last season when I was in Arkansas, seeing him mark that bird, go out, get the bird, and come back to me and bring it to my hand, it put all the pieces together for me. I have did a lot of training with Odie, one-on-one training, so to see it come full circle was a beautiful moment for me.
Hey, stop moving. I'm so emotional, I had to hug a tree. 10-yard chip shot like a dove tee. And if a mallard got the tree, you know it's OB. We gon' shoot him right down, dead in the beat.
Oh, good boy,
Odie.
Hard work, dedication. Put your mind to something, I promise you can get it done. Stay consistent at whatever you want. You get it, baby. Ducks aren't really down, but we're making the most of what we got. I mean, we're killing birds, we're learning more about the birds, learning more about the hole. So this trip is really beneficial because, I mean, we're not losing anything, we're just learning. And every day you're learning, you're doing something right.
Nice shot, Gage.
Man, I don't know what D Moore's talking about. I'm cleaning up off his mistakes.
How many ducks on the strap are yours, Gage? Let me know how many on that strap are yours. We waiting.
Ducks up top, so we bring them down low. Cleaned up the first bunch, soap scum on my tote. Keep a duck call in my hands like Josh Raggio. Got a strong north wind, Mondo Wise in the hole. 20 gauge popping, like pop rocks.
Just we shot some good local birds, and man, once we shot at them, it's pretty much over for the rest of the weekend. So man, we're just looking forward to these cold fronts, these big pushes of birds, and man, when December hits, it's on.
So we seen a fair amount of birds in the area. It wasn't Mondo Wise everywhere, but it was enough to say, hey, we should hunt here. I do feel like those were local birds, and I do feel like we need some weather.
Out of way, no dog season, let's get it started. I drive to the hole just like James Harden. Cortez on my skin, swear to God, I'm feeling saucy. X a duck out just like they cross me. Truck so big, swear to God, I gotta jump in. Back the boat down the ramp, then I gon' jump in. I'ma hunt every day, then I'm alive. I keep that 40 by my side like 39.
Damn, cuts. Man, y'all can kiss my